Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Best of PowerPoint, and in this all new quick tip series. Today I'm going to share a very useful feature of PowerPoint, and the name of this feature is Animation Painter. So as you can see, I have inserted three images in my slide and I want to animate all the three images exactly the same. So beginning with the first image, let's add fade entrance effect to it. Open the animations pane and open the effect options. Under the timings tab, select start after previous, set the duration to 1 second and click OK. Now let's add another animation effect to this image, and this time I will add teeter effect. Again open the effect options of this effect, select start after previous and add a delay of about 0.5 seconds. The final animation effect which I am going to add to this image will be the fade exit effect. Again open the effect options, select start after previous and set the duration to 1 second. Let's see what we have achieved so far. So the image makes an entrance, teeters up and down, and takes the exit. Now I want that these three animation effects be applied to the other images too, along with the same properties. One way is that I can add these effects separately and set the properties of each effect one by one. However, it will become very much difficult and time consuming if the number of images is very large. Therefore, I will use the amazing feature of PowerPoint called Animation Painter. Select the base image from which you want to copy the effects to the other images, and under the Animations tab, you can find the Animation Painter. Click on it and then click on the desired image on which you want all these animation effects to be copied. And it's done. Similarly, copy the animation effects to the third image. So basically, it is just a copy and paste tool for the animation effects. Let's see what we have achieved now. Perfect. With just a click of my mouse, I have applied same animations with their same respective properties to all the other images. And not only images, you can use the Animation Painter for text and other objects also. And this saves me a lot of time when I have to apply a large number of complex animations to a large number of objects. So that's it guys. I hope that this video was helpful to you. Please like and share the video and don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Thanks for watching and see you in my next video.